So I am going to just present some products, details of some products which I have developed. So first I will tell something about the need of technological institution. That is, institutions have technology, that technological excellence should be there, and it has to enhance the employability of students. And ideal professional institutions, knowledge in entrepreneurship is needed, then knowledge in intellectual property rights, and inclination for service to the society. Three things are to be imparted to the students. Now, the use of technological knowledge, technical knowledge directed for taking up jobs, developing products and processes, then protecting the knowledge or know-how through patents, and using the products for the benefit of the society. So that kind of mindset must be developed in the minds of the students. So technical institutions and the society. So actually technical institutions are natural, should be natural incubators of creativity and a big role to play in boosting the economy, and the professional capable of creating their own jobs. So that is the need of the hour. We can see that there is tremendous opportunity for India. Average age of the population by the year 2020 will be 29 years, against 40 years in USA, 46 in Europe, and 47 in Japan. So Indian youth are having a very bright future. And the labor force in the world will decline by 4% in industrial countries and in 5% in China, while in India it is going to be increased by 32%. That is what statistics tell. So India will have to create 1 million new jobs every month for the next 20 years to give job to all people. That is a very tough job. And to cope with this, encourage students to become entrepreneurs. Provide knowledge in intellectual property rights and develop a flair for serving the society. So that's a very important thing. Serve the society. Now, I am going to present three things. I am not going to elaborate. We will not elaborate a discussion on it. Three products I have developed with the help of the students, so that they can give it as an example to the students and they can also become an entrepreneur. First one is a portable dual-powered grain transporter cum dryer with a variable height and the patent application. And second one is a gravity-assisted dehusker for coconut dehusking. Kerala, lot of coconuts are there and dehusking is a problem. Developed two types. Another one, a gravity-assisted coconut dehusker with dual piercing head. So that will, even women can empower women. All the three products will help the women workers. It is reducing their muscular needs. Muscular power can be reduced. Now, first one, portable dual-powered grain transporter cum dryer with variable height and flow rate. I am giving it a name, Farmate 1. We have given name also, and we already, the pilot project is lot of some 12 or 13 such units are working in Kerala at different parts, and Raidco has come forward to market this product. So this is the photograph of it. It's a winnowing unit, and the grain is transported from the heap to the winnowing machine with the help of a screw conveyor. It is a multi-purpose screw conveyor. Now, this is, I am not giving all the details, just some ideas I am giving. It consists of a heat exchanger. That's a simple heat exchanger that can work with the waste, agro waste. A screw conveyor is there, and a motor that is running the screw conveyor. And there is a winnowing unit which will remove all the chaff and all the things from the grain. Now, it can also be used as a transporter. So, agriculture, this is my own farm. I am an agriculturist also. And during the harvest season, some 10 tons of paddy will come in one load of truck. And all the things, the labor, you have to carry it on head and put it. That can be reduced. You can put it and this unit can transport it from the heap. And it can also be used for putting it in the sack, packing it. And this was given a lot of importance. Even the minister is looking at it. He put it in the science expo, and the government is also supporting this product because that is supporting, that is helping the farmers in a big way. Now, that is a news clip that appeared in a local newspaper. The features of this machine is, it's portable and can easily be shifted from one place to other. The rate of flow of grain transported can be varied. If you want to transport it fast, it can be done. Then the height through which the grain can be transported can also be changed because of the inclination can be changed.
And wet grain can be dried by heating the screw conveyor using a heat exchanger that is working on agro waste. And equipment can be simply as a grain transporting device. And winnowing is also possible with this. And the winnowing unit can be detached so that it can be easily transported from one place to other. And this agro waste, rice husk, coconut husk, all these things are used for fuel. And the unit can be operated in a single phase power supply. And the unit can also be run using an IC engine so that in a farm, they can take this machine and do it because it can work on an IC engine also. So if the grain is transported in a pit, it can be repeatedly put into the winnowing machine, and drying is very easy, and 1.5 tons of paddy can be dried in an hour, and the unit can handle about 1.5 tons of paddy per hour. I will show the video at the end. I have prepared three videos also for the management of time. I will postpone it to the end. Now the second one is gravity assisted dehusker for coconut dehusking. So this is also meant for women. Women can easily dehusk coconuts because there is a laborious process, and I have developed applied mechanics. I have used the principles of applied engineering mechanics, and the students, I gave some projects, I give some instruction to the students and developed. I can show this device also, the video of it is also available. And there is a handle, and when the handle is pulled down, the coconut will be dehusked. So the loading lever is there, and the coconut is just put on the top. When the loading lever is pulled down, the coconut will be dehusked. It will be applying force on it. And the interesting aspect of this is it is a gravity assisted device. So the muscular force needed and also the body weight is assisting the coconut dehusking process, so that the dehusking has become very easy. 1000 coconut, even I dehusked. And even ladies, women workers are very much willing to use this machine. Now I will show a video at the end. A lady is dehusking using this device, and this I will show another thing, another device also I have developed, in which both the hands can be used. So in a, if there is a car, all four wheel, 1000 kg is the weight, 1000 by 4 will be the weight on each wheel. Like that, if you are using both your hands, the weight, that the force that is needed for dehusking will be distributed, and the work can be easily done. So if FS is the force needed to dehusk, FS by 2 is needed for one hand. So that force needed will be equal to the dehusking force minus the body force. Body force is actually acting in the downward action. Gravity is assisting it. So the force needed will be very much less, and even women can use it very effectively. So in this model, both the hands are used. This makes dehusking more comfortable, as muscular force needed for dehusking is shared by both the hands. Two piercing heads are used, and the dehusking machine will almost become horizontal when it is not in operation, so it is inherently safe also. So it will be looking like this. It will be it will become horizontal. When the force is applied, it will become horizontal. Now the device has got a wide acceptance. The agricultural officer is inspecting it. Lot of people are after this, especially women workers are very much happy about the operation. Now I will, the main thing is the products were used to kindle interest of the students in product development and IPR. So that is the need of the hour. It's not simply job ready engineers is not the need of the hour. People, the students should be able to do something with their own ideas, and some products should come. And the teachers must be example for that. Yeah, I have developed it, so you can also develop, you have to tell. And this product is working like that. All the three products are cost effective and are field tested. And Regional Agro Industries Corporation is taking this. It has come forward to manufacture and market it. Now I will show some videos and the three products, videos of these three products. So actually some 12 or 15 people are needed to do this work. Now only two people are working. Some 4 tons of paddy, it will dry. One lady will just push it to the screw conveyor, and the screw conveyor will transport it to the winnowing unit. And from the winnowing unit, all the waste products will be removed. The husk will be removed, rice husk will be removed, and the pure, the removed, the better things, the grains will come out. And this unit can be easily handled by a single phase power supply. And if in a farm there is no power supply, one IC engine can be used. We can just connect that pulley to an IC engine and that will work. So this work which is to be done with a lot of muscular strain, people are very happy. One lady, she is very happy. If this machine is not there, she will not be happy. So this kind of thing will not reduce the labor. The labor can be increased. The labor can be made more productive. And the muscular power, less muscular power is needed, so people can work very comfortably. So this is about the first product that farm made, which is also some 20 such units are there in operation, and we want to put more number of units with the help of the government. So this is about the first product. Now the second one is the coconut dehusker. This one is also helping the women.
Unfortunately,
it is
a cherupo cover the mighty cherupung and don't drink another card of the mighty.
So very easily the coconut can be, sorry that it is coming like this, I don't know what has happened. So a woman can easily dehusk coconuts, and that will reduce their muscular effort in a very drastic manner. Now this is the one in which both the hands are, he is using both the hands.
Just three iterations,
one coconut can be dehusked. And this will be a big boost, or that will help the farmers in a very good way for dehusking coconuts. So this is all I want to present, because all these things are applied for patent, and other things I can even show the actual model later. Thank you. I take this opportunity to thank all the office bearers for giving me an opportunity to be in this August gathering. So I thank once again for giving me an opportunity. Thank you.